Hey everyone, so today I wanted to talk about what I consider the most important aspect of archery form, especially for traditional archers and barebow archers, and that's alignment. So what alignment is, and well, let's start with just some basic background on big picture items with archery form. What we're trying to do is, everything in our archery form, basically what we're trying to do is not use muscle, except for very specific amounts of muscle, and use our bone structure, our skeletal structure, to support the weight of the bow. And that's because muscles are kind of weak compared to our bones. They're not consistent, they're squishy. And so, you know, if you think you want to have like the same amount of tension in your bicep or hold a position where like a half squat, half arm curl like this, you want to do that the same way every time, that's impossible. But if you want to just stand here straight like that, use your natural body structure, that's really easy. It's the same concept with archery form. We want to use our natural body structure, support the weight of the bow. We want to relax most of our muscles, except for the ones that are directly engaged in the shot process. So that's the idea. And alignment is the biggest component of that. So what alignment is it's your body positioning. So your shoulders are aligned and pointed to the target, and your drawing arm, elbow, and your forearm are behind the arrow shaft. So at full draw, you have a really strong holding position, and that's the important thing. So at full draw, you can be really relaxed and supporting the weight of the bow. Again, not using a lot of muscle, but you're super strong and solid because you've achieved a position that allows you to use your natural bone structure. So how do you get yourself into alignment? And so this is how I do it. There are more than one way. So, you know, if this doesn't work for you, go ahead, look for some other coaches that are teaching another method that might work for you. But here's how I do it. It all starts with how you grip the bowstring. So when you hook the bowstring, look at your wrist. If your wrist is like this, and you have a bend in it where it's making an L shape, that you're already setting yourself up for failure, because if you were to just draw the bow back like that, your elbow is going to stick way out, and there's no way you can get back into alignment without bending your wrist back. So you want to start with your wrist in a nice straight line. So imagine, you know, if you're holding onto something, and this is the most natural way for you to support your weight. You can see how your wrist is in a nice straight line there with your forearm. So that's how we're going to grip the bowstring. All right. And then we're going to bring the bow up. And then as we're drawing, we're rotating our shoulders. So Our shoulders are kind of slightly open. You know, you'll see some people start really open and then do a much bigger movement. That's never really worked for me. So for me, my shoulders are maybe at a 45 degree angle to the target. And then as I'm drawing back, they rotate and then point towards the target. Now, an important thing to note is you're not really forcing those shoulders super hard, and you don't need to like put a lot of effort into that. You know, I don't want anyone to be at full draw and really pushing, you know, that shoulder that way, that one that way, and really trying to twist like that, because that's going to cause a lot of muscle tension, a lot of fatigue, and a lot of issues. So just get them into alignment, and that's, don't use any extra muscle there. So now you're most of the way back, and your shoulders are in alignment, you're coming into anchor. And this is, you know, the final step, or one of the final steps, and a really important one, because, so let's say you have that good wrist alignment, your shoulders are there, and you were to just come into anchor. You're pretty close to being in really good alignment. That elbow's just gonna stay just outside, and when you shoot, you're gonna be much more prone to collapse with that position. But if you do this final step, you'll get into that really good strong holding position, and you're gonna feel the difference. One thing I want to just mention real quick is if you have a stretch band or light bow, now is the time to use it when you're learning new aspects of archery form. So you don't want to be using a 60-pound bow to be learning these things for the first time. It's not super forgiving, so use something really light, you know, like a 30-pound bow or a stretch band. So as you're coming into full draw, what you want to do, either you can hit anchor, which is what I do. I hit anchor, and then with my drawing arm elbow, so it's here, and then what I do is I make a check mark with that elbow. So I'm at anchor, and then a check mark, and what that does is, if I were to just draw straight in, my rear shoulder is at a slight angle facing that way, but by doing that little check mark move, it brings that shoulder into alignment, and now, and you will feel almost immediately your scapula get into position, and then you can feel your back really well. If you're one of these people who you're not feeling your back super well and having a hard time with back tension, try that move and you'll feel your back engage. So, and some people, they find it easier is before they get to anchor, they do that move. You watch a lot of the top archers, both Olympic recurve and barbell archers. You'll see them doing some variation of this. For me, it's easier just to get to anchor and finish that swoop. Okay? So you'll feel that. And then what your job is to just really focus on this elbow and keep it moving back and around and keeping that movement and that tension going that way. So you're at full draw and all you're focusing on is keeping tension moving in that direction. It's not going to move a lot, and that's what you're looking for, but you'll feel the tension build as you're at anchor, and then as you shoot, your hand is going to come crisply off the string. And when you're at anchor, you really want to be paying attention to tension in your bicep and your forearm. If you feel any tension when you're at a holding position and building tension in your back, make a conscious effort to relax your forearm and your bicep and really let your elbow carry all the weight throughout the rest of the shot. And that's going to clean up your release, prevent collapsing. You're going to have really good, crisp shot. All right, so those are the basics of alignment. Give it a try. Again, if this method doesn't work for you, please go search out other coaching. There's a ton of good ones out there, especially if you can get in-person coaching. I know it's hard right now, but Skype lessons are an excellent alternative. If you need some references, feel free to reach out to me. I'm easy to get a hold of on like Instagram or something like that. Just shoot me a message and I'll do everything I can to help you out. So I hope this video is helpful. We'll see you in the next one.